Alright, we are back. I hope so at least. Let's see if it maybe gets better this time around.
You sound much better now.
Oh, okay, so it probably was like the local recording I did for the first time. I tried this out, but it seems like my computer doesn't work so well with it. Alright, so yeah, ladies and gentlemen, we have a moving picture for once. That is pretty nice, and yeah, that also spells the beginning of this match. I will just shortly introduce everything once more. We have Ubi Team versus Ox GP Red. It's Ubi Team on the blue side, Ox GP Red on the red side. And yeah, Ubi Team comes in as the clear favorite in this first Champions Bracket match. They won their Swiss group round, or Swiss group, no, how do you say it? They won their Swiss group, yeah, that's it. Yeah. And OxGP got 8th, which qualifies them for the upper bracket, the Champions Bracket, but yeah, of course, gives them a pretty hard match at the start, and yeah, let's see what they can do against Ubi Team today or tonight. I am hoping for at least, yeah, some fighting back from them. As we will start the match soon, I hope. Now the match is already delayed by 6 minutes, so yeah, that came in handily for our technical difficulties.
Yeah, now we're on the wrong map.
Yeah.
Nice match we're having here, but it looks like the settings are fixed now. I think we're about to start after the skip.
Yeah, everything fails in this match. We have a bad stream, we have wrong maps on the server, and we have the wrong team. Not Ox GP Black, which is the first lineup, but Ox GP Red, who are actually the second lineup of Ox GP only, but made it into the Champions Bracket. And their mates from Ox GP Black have to play in the Challengers Bracket. But yeah, I think this is a great chance for the Ox GP Red lineup to prove themselves, if they can do something. And we are live in the first round now on TMM Sculpture, which is the first map to be played. And Ox GP not looking too bad in this first round. You have Despairing Goa for Ubi Team takes the lead, and yeah, behind him all 4 Ox GP players are lurking in the shadows and now actually taking the lead, as Ringoa was making a small mistake. Yeah, seems to be the first round for Team Red if it continues like that. Raptors is sneaking in a little bit, can take second place after a mistake of an Orcs GP driver. But overall, this is more than enough for the Red team. We have Ted winning the round with a 50-13. And HB Astronomia coming in third and fourth place, which means the first point for Ox GP.
Yeah, well, that looked promising for Ox GP, and the Ubi Team players not really looking good on this map. A lot of early mistakes in the start, and because of that, deserve 1-0.
Well, we have an interesting fact by Azura. Ubi Team never trains the first map because they think they can get an advantage with that. That is pretty interesting strategy, because of course the pick and ban system kind of works like that. If you lose the first map and then win the second map, you kind of can also choose the third map, is that right? I'm not 100% sure, but that's how it works, I think. So yeah, they can choose the next two maps if they lose this one, of course. But yeah, who knows? For the moment, at least, it looks like Ubi Team is actually trained on this map, as were Zoom, Ringoa and Raptor, all 4 without a mistake, and they can clean sweep Ox GP in this round. Really, really nice performance by Ubi Team, and we have a tight score at 1-1.
Yeah, well, that was kind of opposite from the first round. Now Ubi Team destroying, so I don't think they have this 2-map plan in the back.
Who knows?
But yeah, quite interesting strategy, to be honest.
Yeah, I'm hearing it for the first time as well. Looks like a fun fact, Azura Modseed is saying in the chat. Yeah, maybe this is a fun fact. But this round kind of looks in that way again. We have, oh my god, HB crashing big time into the pole. But let's have a look at the top spots. I think only one Ubi player is in the first spots. No, it's Aswar and Vingoa actually.
Yeah, but Aswar falling a little bit behind. Peems is catching up to him in a now three-way fight between Aswar, Raptor and Peems. And in the front it is Vingoa with just some thousands in front of Ted, ooh, but he stays in front, will take first. Oh, this is will be a close round, but it will be the Ubi team round. Because Raptor finishes in 5th place and then Zoom in 7th place, and that is enough. So close round here, and the match is looking not looking that one-sided as we expected.
Yeah, really, really close round coming in, positions 5 to 8 decided that one. And Ubi team can take the lead. Azura with the wall of text in the chat. I'm sorry, I can't read that right now. Maybe you can give him.
Yeah, it's an just about the. Like, it's basically what you explained.
Ah, alright.
That if they lose the first, they can pick the next two maps. If they win the second.
Alright, so.
Yeah, but I don't know. That's a good tactic.
We can, I guess, go back to the match then. We have Zoom with really, really good speed. Charging in front of the two OxGP guys we are specking right now. But overall it's looking to be a close round again, as Doom is also touching the wall, sliding too much to the inside, wanted to take that turn a little too close to the wall, and yeah, touched with that, and oh my god, that was just a lag.
Whoa.
That looked a bit scary, but OxGP is actually able to clock in another round for themselves. Nice team performance again, as well with the victory, but the other Ubi guys not looking too strong at all, especially Raptor. I think he didn't had a clean round so far. Maybe he had, but didn't see him too much in the first positions. That means, of course, that we are tied again at 2-2. And OxGP so far fighting back really, really greatly, you have to say. Ubi team with a lot of big names in the Trackmania scene. And OxGP, I have to say, I didn't know a single guy of them before the match. But they are doing not too bad right now. And it seems like they can challenge Ubi team at least on this map. Oh my god, the double mistake by Team Ubi, was it? No, there are still two Ubi guys in front there, so it was a OxGP driver who crashed. But overall this could still be a red round, because Rigoa falling down, Ted was able to overtake him and is not able to win, but clock in a second place, 50.09 by Zoom. He wins the round, and overall this should be a OxGP round. Just due to the fact that, no it's not, oh wow.
No, it's Ubi round, because with the draw in the last four positions and then Zoom and Rigoa ahead of the other two Ox players, so it's the third point for Ubi team. But yeah, a lot of mistakes, and again it was Raptor who did a big mistake in that pole section, where you were like, oh, two players failed. But yeah, still managed to get the round, and they're now in the lead again. And it's always like they have the much better start. We see Rigoa in first place together with Aswar, and then the OxGP players a little bit behind after the start. And yeah, here you can see much more speed by the Ubi team players. But where are Raptor and Zoom? Oh, there was a big mistake, I think, by OxGP player. Yeah, that was Astronomia, so he is out of this. So in the top, the other players need to take first
Ted
and maybe second, but yeah, right now it looks like an ace, only Peems is up there, and HB maybe, but yeah, Raptor with a good end, and that will be the ace and the 4-2 overall score.
And the first time below 50 as well, clocking in a 59.95, great time by him. We sadly don't see the Daddy Mania records on the server, so I can't tell you guys exactly where they are, but I guess you know better anyway, at least most of you, if you are trained the map maybe, or yeah, know it a bit. Then you can maybe tell me what the Daddy Mania record on this track is. Would be nice to know, but for now we should refocus on the match, as Ubi team is running away a little bit now with a 4-2 score. They are taking the lead by 2 points and looking not too bad in this round here again. Aswar, Rigoa and Raptor, all three for Ubi team in the first few positions. Zoom also not too far behind. And only Ted can interrupt the Ubi guys in front right now. But doesn't look he can do too much.
Look, again, almost like an ace. Because all the other OxGP players have made mistakes, and yeah, Ted will... Oh wait, no! Raptor did a small mistake at the ending, so yeah, no ace. And okay, we get the confirmation, WR is 46, okay. So yeah, they're driving 0.5 behind WR here.
Yeah, that is pretty decent, I'd say, but I have seen better, I have to say, in last week's match of HPD. HP3 drivers were really, really sick last week. Onyo, for example, driving like 0.2 behind the Daddy Mania records, multiple runs in a row. That was insane to watch. Wow. And yeah, I really think we have to watch out for HPD. They are looking like a really great team that could make it until or up to the final if they continue to perform like that. Right now though, it's UBI Team and OxGP playing, of course, so UBI Team in the lead again, Zoom Ringoa and Raptor looking pretty decent. We had a mistake by Eswa, I think, but OxGP... Yeah,
Eswa retired actually, so there will only be three UBI Team players finishing, but they're first, third and fourth, and I think that will be enough to win this round. Is that true?
Well, this should be a UBI round.
Yeah.
Or what do you... Yeah. It's the 6-2, and with that we are heading to match point on this track. 7 points, of course, is the limit. You want to reach first with your team. And UBI Team only 1 point away, and we have already a really, really sick mistake by Astronomia. He did the double crash basically, but Ringoa, oh my god, came to a full stop. He nearly crashed onto his head, I feel like.
But and also Raptor is behind, so Raptor and Ringoa at last two positions. So Ezra and Zoom have to take first and second to make this a draw. That will be incredibly difficult because Ted and Peeps are the same pace as Ezra. Ted actually overtaking him, but Ezra comes back with good speed, goes much more to the inside, but gets a bad line. Ted going for a good line towards the ending and overtakes Ezra, and with that secures the round. Nice job by Ted.
Well, even Astronomia, who got that huge crash in the beginning of the map, can overtake Raptor on Ringoa. That, of course, spells the point for OxGP, and they will decrease their disadvantage to 6-3, still a pretty big lead by UBI Team, of course. But that round showed that UBI is not too secure on this map yet. They made a lot of mistakes already and are in the lead, mostly due to the fact that they have the faster players. But OxGP, they look well prepared, and I really like to see that. As a team who is such a clear underdog as they were before the match, it's not that easy to motivate yourself, but yeah, they did a pretty good job, I think. Even though in this round it looks pretty hard for them to deny UBI Team again. It's Aswa in the lead. Ted is the only one for OxGP who is maybe able to do something, but he had to release to get that turn there. And that means, yeah, it's gonna be a blue round this time around. As we're 49.77, that is actually a pretty sick time. First time really see a really, really fast time on this map.
No, I think it was the match PB, if I remember correctly. Yeah, but with that, first map goes to UBI Team. And yeah, it was basic just Ted out of the Orcs players who performed kind of well. If you look at the total scores, Astronomia with 40 points, HB and Peams with only 29 points, and yeah, that is definitely not enough to beat UBI Team.
Yeah, not enough to beat them, and yeah, if the strategy of UBI Team failed now, we don't know what they will do now. But I guess if the strategy was to lose the first map, they would have driven a bit worse, probably.
Well, maybe OxGP had the same strategy.
Oh.
And now they are two mapping.
I'm thinking about a strategy when when that really would happen, like, how would the match look like? Like, everyone breaking before the finish line?
No, I don't
not
know.
Wanting to finish? I think it would be really awkward.
Yeah.
Alright.
Thanks. But yeah, we saw the Poco Loco ban by Ubi Team, and OrcsGP picked Allure. So we're on Allure by Nevermind now. Pretty cool map.
Yeah, you think so?
Yeah.
I didn't really like it when I played it before the stream, but yeah, go ahead, you probably know it better than I do.
Yeah, well, we drove it, I don't know against which team, but I think we lost it. Well, yeah, but I like driving it. So, some good turns, and for me, it was like you were able to save it a lot on this map. So if you were, just about to save, you could do that very good. But yeah, let's see how OrcsGP and Ubi Team are prepared on this one. I think, well, what's WR here? Does anyone know that?
You can maybe check on Mania Exchange, I don't know.
Let's see.
Well,
we have this tricky start here with this narrow corner where you need to steer at the correct time. Then, of course, this first passage here over this quarter pipe where you want to go with full speed is kind of tricky. Followed by this long full speed section. And as I mentioned, it's a pretty speedy map. And then this turn here is really hard to judge on the blue part, where Ted just touched. So let's follow Ringoa towards the ending. Yeah, then we have this right-hander, not too difficult. And then, we're coming towards the ending. We have this long turn where I don't know if some players still go inside pole, but some might go inside pole, some might go outside pole. I'm not really sure what's faster. But yeah, we will see what the players are doing there.
Yeah, for me, just the start already was too tough to drive consistently, basically. Maybe have to see how the players will approach it. But yeah, for me, it was like really, really tough. Like this narrow part and then the wall to the right always came way too close for me. But it seems like the players are able to do it a little bit better than me. And yeah, we could go live soon. Let's see. Looking to the lineups, maybe we have Aswo, Ringoa and Raptor playing again, and Zoom will be swapped out for Punky, or Punk, as he's only named in-game right here. Let's just call him Punk.
Punky. I'd call him Punky.
Punky. Oh, yeah, like I think Punky is his. Punky is his usual name. Yeah. Okay. Then let's stay with Punky.
Yeah. That's good. Okay. And WR is 49-25 by Magorian, as it looks like.
Oh. Okay. So pretty similar to the previous track. So we think we'll see a lot more times below 50, but still times will be around that probably most of the time. Two warm-ups still left. That gives us time to maybe take another look onto the players playing for OrcsGP. And it's Astronomia, Ted and Peams who will drive again, and Psycho Oquak. That is an interesting name. We'll be playing.
It's just Psycho, I think.
I like Psycho Oquak. That is a fun name. No, but yeah, let's call him Psycho. Guess that's enough. And yeah, as this is the pick by OrcsGP, I guess, it's gonna be interesting to see if they can maybe challenge Ubi Team a little bit more than they would do on the first map, where they still got three rounds, which is pretty good for them, I think. Don't know what they expected before the match, but I guess they can be confident going into the second map. as they probably are a bit better prepared on this one as Ubi team, just judging from the fact that they picked the map.
Yeah, I think so too. Why would you pick a map when you're not prepared? So yeah, they should do quite well on this one. And yeah, of course, they need to win this map. Of course, the deciding map. By the way, do we have tennis mode?
Yeah, we have tennis mode in the playoffs. And we have a host by Necroa. That is pretty nice to see. Thanks, mate, for the host. And hello everyone who is joining the stream just now. We are casting the Champions Bracket match between Ubi Team and OrcsGP Red. And OrcsGP won the first map with a 7-3 score. But Ubi Team, yeah, they looked kinda shaky, I have to say. Had a lot of mistakes, and OrcsGP... Yeah, they also lost, I think, two really close rounds, so they could have even scored more points than the three they did. Look pretty well prepared. Of course, they don't really have the speed of the Ubi guys. That is kind of to be expected if you look at the names that are driving right here. Ubi team driving with a lot of really decent French players. For example, Ringoa, Aswa, who were driving for E-Corp before the team disbanded. And the OrcsGP players are kind of unknown, at least for me. And yeah, but really looking forward what they can do on this map as we are going live on Allure by Nevermind. And yeah, you can take the first round if you want.
Yeah, we see good starts by both of the teams. Thing, no really big mistakes so far. Astronomia is a little bit behind for Orcs. Also Psycho a little bit behind. Ubi team player staying strong at the top, but Ted wants to occupy the first place, gets a really good turn around that pole and manages to take first place, but it's not enough because all the other Ubi team players are in the positions 2-5, and with that it's 1-0 for Ubi team again.
A great start to the match by Ubi team with yeah, four players driving into the finish without a major mistake. That is a pretty good start to have for the team. And again, another mistake by an OrcsGP driver. Who was it?
It was Psycho, but also Ringoa and Peams with mistakes.
Ooh.
So yeah, two Orcs players and one Ubi team player down. So looking better for Ubi team, judging by the mistakes. But it's again Ted, yeah, looking strong on this map. Is challenging Aspa for the first place. Has good speed over that blue board. Manages to come closer. And actually, oh, goes really close to the pole, and they see some different lines, but Ted and Aspro, Ted has it much better, but Aspro comes back with more speed. So this fight for first place, I think it's important. And Ted going a little bit more for the inside line, but Aspro stays in front. With that, secures the first place and another round for Ubi team.
Yeah, this one was a lot closer though. We have the tie in the bottom four positions, and then Ubi team won the two remaining one-on-ones, basically. Aswar, with 15 points, best Ubi team driver so far. He won the round, and yeah, with that, got his team another point, 2-0. Great start for Ubi into the second map, and yeah, OrcsGP, even though they picked this map, not looking too great so far. They probably have to rely a little bit on Ubi team making mistakes as well, so that's probably the issue right here, because Ubi team looks pretty well prepared on this map as well, I think. Let's maybe see Ringoa. He has a great overview, and we see that just the Ubi team guys yeah, are the faster people on the server right here, the faster drivers. OrcsGP, they look yeah, pretty decent in this round. Not a lot of mistakes by them, but yeah, Ubi team is just faster. Aswa with a 49.63, already a decent time by him again. Hey, he carries his team hard right now. Second win in a row by him. And yeah, another point for Team Blue. 3-0 right now.
Yeah, but still a good round overall. But yeah, you just see that the Ubi team players are a little bit faster than the OrcsGP drivers. And that is what is making difference right now.
Psycho, with a really unnecessary mistake, touched the wall on the blue part, on the tiny blue part, and what?
And Astronomia with the full stop. No, and I think he has to retire.
Oh my god.
For the safe way. I think he thought he could make the jump and didn't know there was a different way. Oh, but he... okay, well, that's not speculative anymore. Yeah, in the top, DS were in the lead, and then Punky and Ted and Ringoer really close together, but yeah, it will most likely be a Ubi team round, even though Punky, I think, did a mistake there. Yeah, drops behind, but Asper will once again secure the round with a 49.5, really good time. Then Ted with 0.7 in second, but then all the other Ubi team drivers. Yeah, and that's the next point for Ubi team.
At a 4-0 already, and Ubi really showing their strength on this map right here. OxGP, they don't really stand a chance up until now. Also in the last round they had a lot of mistakes. I think there was an OxGP driver dropping down again.
Yep,
already.
Peams.
Yeah, Peams and wow.
And again, and Astronomia both are dropping behind, but also Ringoer now. So maybe this is the chance. And yeah, for me Ringoer's not really looking good on this map. Is the worst Ubi team driver, just judging by the team scores.
Yeah, 5-year ban incoming. I needed to say that, guys, sorry. But Ubi team, yeah, looking great again with Aswa and Raptor in the lead, and Aswa already hard carrying again in this round. 31 points to his name, he's the fastest driver on the server, and will only improve this score with this round. Raptor coming close, but will not overtake him. And maybe this will be a tie, but Peams is too far behind, I think, yeah. This is another point for Ubi team. A close one, but yeah, the 5-0. And now OrcsGP really have to step up the game if they want to turn this around.
Yeah, well, if you look at the total score, it's basically just Ted. And then, yeah, Psycho, Astronomia and Peams are at the last three positions. Oh yeah, and alone you can't really carry a team to the victory. And yeah, I don't know, they're not really looking good at the start, especially. Psycho again doing the mistake and is doing what Astronomia did two rounds ago. So yeah, does not really look that they are well prepared. And once again, it's Astro on the lead. And then Ted and Peams and Raptor are up there. And also Astronomia, so maybe it's not looking that bad in this round. Ringoer has made a mistake. Punky is a little bit behind, so... Yeah, now it's up to Ted to stay in second place, but he doesn't do so. Raptor overtakes him there, and with that, it again the Ubi round.
Wow, such a close round as well, and I wouldn't necessarily say that OxGP is not looking well prepared. I just feel like they feel the need to risk all those turns and the difficult start in particular. You already said it, OxGP... not looking great in the start whatsoever, and I feel like they just feel the pressure of Ubi team winning round after round, and they feel like they have to do something, and yeah, that is probably one of the reasons why they do those mistakes.
Yeah, and again it is Psycho crashing at the same power where he crashed last round,
and Ringoer as well with a mistake.
Yeah, Ringoer did an earlier mistake, but every time in that turn there's one OxGP player crashing, a Psycho crashing again, so he will definitely be in last. But in the top, this time it is Ted coming towards the second to last turn, followed by Punky and Aswer.
Oh my god, that's Astronomia.
Inside line, but loses some speed. Ted with good speed, also Aswer with good speed, and oh, Aswer coming really close. But yeah, this... should be the GG. What happened to the other Orcs players?
Yeah, they crashed in the last turn, basically. I kind of saw it because I was on Astronomia. He had a crucial mistake, and then Peams, I think, kissed the pole in the end. Couldn't decide if he should go left or right. Then went center. And yeah, that made Ubi team score the 7th point here, and that spells the GG for them. Yeah, pretty easy walk into the... second round of the winner bracket for Ubi team in the end. You have to say that last map was really one-sided. Yeah. But OrcsGP, I think they did a pretty good job they of course didn't expect to end up in the upper bracket in the first place, so yeah, it's kind of hard for them I guess now, but maybe their teammates in the challengers bracket will do a lot better then, as they will probably face quite some easier opponents. So maybe they can at least, yeah, cheer for their mates and yeah, they have a match to play still. That is should not be forgotten. They will be playing at 8:30 p.m. again, and their opponent will be THE Blue, and I'm gonna cover this match as well. So if you wanna watch that, you can stay on this channel. I will, yeah, go offline for 1 hour and then be back with that match. But yeah, let's see what OrcsGP maybe can do in this match. Wasn't enough against Ubi team, sadly. But yeah, I think you wanted to say something, maybe.
Not really, but yeah, of course they have the chance to go through the lower bracket, but of course against THE Blue it will be hard.
Yeah, another hard match they're gonna be facing there.
Yes, so maybe they thought they could get into the challengers bracket and maybe win there, because yeah, they have the potential. But yeah, in the end they ended up, as you said, in the champions bracket. And yeah, they're really, I think, one of the worst teams there.
Yeah, and I don't know, OrcsGP maybe needed a wild card to swap the teams around. That would fix a lot of those matchmaking issues. But, yeah, of course, not really possible. So, OrcsGP Red, yeah, as we said, have a tough road to take if they want to survive this week. But, yeah, they have another chance, and we will cover that at 8:30 p.m. So, stay tuned for that. And until then, I want to thank you guys for tuning in. Was a lot of fun to cast this match, and I hope you're going to be back in 1 hour for the other match. See ya until then, guys. Bye bye.
See ya.